Hey, what's up, everybody? It's vrgamerdude here, and today we are finally going to get a look at Narcosis. That's right, it has fully released today, and I am chomping at the bit to put on my dive suit and get down there and find out what's going on the ocean floor. So come along with me, and let's see if I can survive the depths in Narcosis. All right, everybody, here we are, and we are finally in Narcosis. And I wanted to take a couple of seconds to kind of talk about the menu here, because one thing I think is awesome that Honor Code did is they gave us a ton of options to customize this game the way that we want it to be played. So something I wanted to point your attention to here, you know, obviously the VR settings, and man, thank you for giving me the ability to turn a couple of things off. First and foremost, gaze navigation. So no head look, I've got a disconnected head. Secondly, peripheral occlusion. You know, it does that whole eagle flight thing where everything kind of zooms in and gets black in your peripheral. You can turn that off. So thank you very much. Camera shake, we don't want. You know, head bob, we don't want. And my favorite, we have smooth rotation. So if you need step rotation, you got it. But you know, for hardcore vets like me, I prefer the smooth. So anyway, just wanted to go through that before we started. If you buy the game, you're gonna be able to tailor it to your needs. And once again, Honor Code, thank you so much for doing that. All right. Let's go.
Oceanova was once in a lifetime. They're breaking new ground, making something meaningful. Mining methane hydrate frozen beneath the seabed. There's alternatives, but none so plentiful. It's clean and safe. I couldn't say no.
Sorry about your weekend, but someone had to draw the short straw.
Yeah, it's always me. I always get the short straw.
New suit, same rules. Give me a sec.
Okay.
Okay, instruments. O2.
Check.
Flares and thrust.
Check and check.
Here, you know the drill. You're stressed, panicking, breathing hard.
Freaking out, man.
Sensors tripped. As you know, your O2 burns down a lot faster under stress. Anyway.
All right, so looks like the controls, even though I changed them to smooth, it still says step rotation here, but rest assured, we have it on smooth rotation.
Let's see.
So.
Scrubbers, check. Temp, check. Lights, check. Camera.
What's going on? Whoa. And here we are walking on the ocean floor, and damn, this looks good. Oh, hey, fish. I don't know, it's something about these underwater games that it doesn't even have to be a horror game, and if I'm in like a dive suit and I'm underwater, it kind of terrifies me. And I don't know why. I think that's awesome, you can see your breath against the inside. No, okay, it's random. For a minute there, I thought it was actually working with me exhaling, which would have been an awesome mechanic, man. Just, you know, I wish some devs would actually take note that there's a mic on the Rift. Do some cool stuff like that, you know? Got me a knife. Super sampled at 1.5, this is looking really sweet. What's going on? Everything's getting gray again.
Whoa! Something's still. still not.
Oh, now I'm back in the pool. Must have been a simulation.
One more time. Whenever you're ready.
Okay. There we go. We've got some thrusters.
All good. Let's try it in reverse. Okay, target practice. Fire a couple of flares.
Okay, so let's grab some flares here.
Okay.
So there we go. And
okay.
Bam.
All right.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. You know it's all right, buddy. I got this.
Navsys, check. Thruster, check. Launcher. And check.
We got it.
Let's get out of here.
Damn straight.
Grab while we can.
Let's do it. Gives you a little bit of a sinking feeling. Okay, these don't look like any fish I've ever seen. All this debris flying at me is like really cool effect. I'm getting kind of murky in here. Maybe I should launch a flare. Hey, dude. What's going on, bro? Yeah, you all right? Okay. I'm coming, man. The metal on these surfaces looks really good.
Robots all riled up. Don't want to miss that. I'll circle back with JJ tomorrow. Get this all wrapped up.
I love the disconnected head, especially since I'm in this nice, expansive helmet.
10:02, February 2nd. We were 50 miles from the epicenter. But an 8 on the Richter scale makes that kind of distance irrelevant.
What's up, bro? Whoa! Hey, what's going on? Okay.
The shockwaves hit 6 minutes later, striking the south face of the HAB first and hardest. 27 minutes in, with that kind of concussive force, even the sealed modules were compromised. After that came the ocean. By 10:33, only safe havens in a sub or one of the suits.
Okay, so it looks like we have been the victim of an underwater earthquake. And man, let me tell you, I do not ever want to know what that would feel like, because that would be absolutely terrifying. Dude. Oh, bro. No. Okay. That was terrifying. Okay, I'm down to 12% oxygen. I really need some oxygen here. In the nick of time. Whew, man, that was giving me anxiety. All sorts of freaky little sea creatures. Whoa, big fish. Oh, hell no. Big spider-looking crab thing. Scared off with my flares. Okay, I know it's a crab, but it looks like a spider, and VR Gamer Dude hates spiders. I absolutely can't stand them. Hearing that thing scurry in the 3D audio is just, it's messing with my head.
Check your gear, trust your training. It's one of the first things you learn. But the second they fail, you fall back on what you know best. For me, it's the list. This time, it wrote itself. Keep breathing. Find others and get the hell out.
Just keep breathing. Just keep breathing. I can hear you, girl. Oh, crap. That thing's gonna jump on me. I just like feel it. Hey, Mr. Spider Crab, don't jump on me now. I'm just gonna go this way. Oh, God, no, there's your little brothers. No. I'm gonna come hide over here and stuff. You don't see me. You don't see me. Just walk on by there. Nothing to see here, sir. Nothing to see here. You. I think the only saving grace is that they're crabs. Oh, hey, current got me. If they were actually spiders, this would have done me in by now. O2 remaining. Love the little bioluminescent plants.
Bearing down on so many levels, it's got to be managed. You can't shake the pressure. Just make your peace with it. Don't let it take the wheel.
Good advice, man. It's good advice. It's easier said than done. Because this has really got my hairs on the back of my neck raised right now. Bottom of this ocean. Really hoping to find a structure here pretty soon. Oh wait, pipeline. If you're watching this in 2D, it's probably not. You're like, dude, this guy's a wuss. Why is he freaking out? There is actually in this game, I mean, if you're in here, if you're in this helmet walking on the bottom of the ocean, there is a sense of anxiety that just starts building up. And unlike other horror games that I've played, it's not all about jump scares in this. I mean, it's literally genuine building terror. Oh, what the hell? Oh, good. I like you. You killed one of those little crab things.
There's protocol for everything. Has to be. something to fall back on. Second guessing puts lives at risk, so it's best to stick to procedure, step by step.
Well, somebody's been here.
So with an all hands call, you head straight for Compass One. Try and reach surface from comms.
All right, well, let's do that. Okay. I was commenting on the bioluminescence plants, and man, let me just stop here for a second and kind of just gel on this. Beautiful. Got the big jellies up there, got the bioluminescent plants. Oh, hey man. Or hey girl. I'm sorry. You don't look like you maked it. Maked it? What the hell am I saying? Get off me. Better run. Oh man, I got my heart racing. Okay. Find Compass One. Oh, get out of this water.
JJ, Demi, is anybody getting this? Does anybody read?
Oh, you're a big daddy. Hey, Compass One. Awesome.
From the outside, the structure seemed intact. So I figured whoever's inside might... Well, maybe it's okay. We ran all kinds of drills. And you... believe you know what to expect? But once I got inside, where it's familiar and you should feel safe... Even though I had to, those first few steps weren't easy.
Okay. Supply storage. Yeah, I'm down to 35% oxygen. I better have some O2 in here. Flares, I need O2. Hey, buddy. Are you a person or are you just a suit? I think you're just a suit.
Hey,
the debris. I mean, this is just really cool. 10%? I just got O2. Uh-oh. Oh, hey, big spider crab thing blocking the door. We are not going to mess with you, but if I don't find some O2, I'm going to die. Oh, there we go. 1%. Oh, man. Talk about in the nick of time. Woo! Ooh, there's one of the spider legs. I like how all the debris kind of moves. No. Okay, now, unless that's some sort of special laptop, I don't know how that would be still operating underwater. Structure shifting. Let's try to get out of here. Just backing up. Just backing up, man. Oh, God. It's going to give me a heart attack. And the lighting in here is really cool. This place is coming apart. Oh, no, no, no! Get off me. Get off me. Yeah, I got you. I got you. You're dead. Oh, cool effect. The blood coming off in the water. Oh, wow. That looks really neat. The detail on these things is insane. Okay, I just want to move you out of the way. I'm going to grab this oxygen. And I haven't been checking it, but you can see, I'm like actually pointing to the helmet, that's how immersed I am. You can see it's actually, well, we'll go ahead and show it here real quick. So you've actually got a database here going on that kind of brings and tells the story a little bit. So, you know, you can see you've got all the different personnel files and we've found a few of them. And, you know, just going to kind of give you a little bit of a backstory on who the people you're finding are and things like that, so... But for the purposes of this video and playthrough, we're just kind of going through it. Probably going to end this up here in just a minute, because I don't want to make this too long. Okay, we got a bunch of suits up in here. Hey, what happened to the door? Whoa! Okay, I think I'm tripping. Something ain't right. I think narcosis is setting in. Okay, that was kind of trippy. And I think that's probably a good place to go ahead and cap this one for the night. But man, let me tell you, if you've got an Oculus Rift and you like the spooky stuff, grab Narcosis. This is just insane. I mean, not cheap jump scares. Oh, there's some jump scares, but you know, it really builds on you. Great atmosphere, great environment. Audio is just freaking me out at every turn. You gotta play this game. So highly, highly recommend Narcosis. I'm gonna throw a link for it down in the description. And of course, you can always just grab it right there from the Oculus store by using that link. But for me tonight, guys, that is gonna do it. Thanks so much for watching to the end of the video. If you made it this far, I know this one was a little bit longer. You guys know I really appreciate it when you do that. And if this was your first time coming by tonight, man, thank you so much for coming by and checking out what I do here on the channel. Couldn't do this without your support. So if you don't mind, hit that subscribe button, smash that like, man. Let me know what you thought down in the comments. I'd really appreciate the feedback. And of course, if you're already a subscriber, guys, we have hit 4,500 subscribers, and I owe that to each and every one of you. So keep doing what you're doing to help me out, man. Like it, tweet it, share it. Let's talk about it. But for me tonight, I can't take it anymore. Narcosis has set in. I gotta go to bed. It's like, have some spooky dreams. This is VR Gamer Dude, signing off tonight, y'all. Peace.